Cookies. Not the kind you eat, but the kind that quietly latch onto your web browser, collecting information as you surf the internet. Every time you visit a new website and see that cookie pop up, you're making a decision that affects your privacy, your security, and even how much you're being watched online. So should you accept cookies? The short answer is, sometimes. But knowing when to say yes and when to hit reject can make all the difference in protecting your personal data. Let's start by explaining what cookies are. Digital cookies, also known as HTTP cookies or browser cookies, are small text files that websites place on your device. They're designed to store bits of information, like your login details, shopping preferences, or browsing behavior, to make your experience on that site more seamless. If you've ever had your cart item saved after closing a tab, or your username auto-filled on a login page, that was thanks to cookies. For the average user, cookies seem helpful, and often they are. Especially on e-commerce websites, they track what you purchase, how often you visit, and help tailor suggestions just for you. There are different types of cookies, and not all are as innocent as they seem. First, you have session cookies. These are temporary and disappear when you close your browser. They help websites remember what you've done during a single visit, like navigating between pages or keeping you logged in. Then there are persistent cookies. These stay on your device long after you've left the site. They remember your preferences, like language, login info, bookmarks. But let's talk about the cookies that should concern you, third-party cookies. These are created not by the site you're visiting, but by other companies, usually advertisers or analytics firms. Their goal is to track your behavior across multiple sites and build a detailed profile of you. If you've searched for something once and then saw ads for it everywhere, then that's third-party cookies in action. Third-party cookies aren't there to help you. They're there to help someone else sell you something. And while targeted ads might seem convenient, they come at the cost of your privacy. Every click, every scroll, every location is being logged, stored, and sometimes sold. Now here's when you should reject cookies without hesitation. 1. If the website isn't secure, check the URL. If it starts with HTTP instead of HTTPS, it's not encrypted. That means any data shared between your browser and the site can be intercepted. Reject those cookies immediately. 2. When using public Wi-Fi. That free airport or cafe connection might seem harmless, but hackers can inject malicious code into unsecured sites and disguise it as a cookie. Accept the wrong one, and someone could steal your identity or gain access to your accounts. 3. If your antivirus flags it, some cookies are outright malicious, and your security software may warn you. Don't ignore that alert. Hit reject. 4. When dealing with sensitive data. If you're entering your social security number, banking details, or anything you wouldn't want shared, don't risk it. Reject any non-essential cookies. But not all cookies are evil. First-party cookies, which are created by the site you're on, can be incredibly useful. They help websites function properly, track technical performance, and improve your experience over time. First-party cookies are the reason you don't have to reset your language settings or re-enter your password every single time. They can even tailor suggestions based on your location, like showing you local hotels or rental cars near you. But even these cookies collect personal data. They can track how long you spend on a page, what you click on, what you search for, and even your physical location. Combined with third-party trackers, it paints a detailed picture of who you are, what you like, and how to market to you. And yes, cybercriminals know this too. A stolen cookie could be used to impersonate you online, bypassing passwords and logging into your accounts. This is known as session hijacking, and it's one of the lesser-known but more dangerous cyber threats out there. You might be wondering why websites ask you to accept cookies. This is because of laws like the GDPR in Europe and CCPA in California. These regulations require websites to be transparent about the data they collect, but you don't have to accept every cookie. In fact, most websites should work just fine if you reject them. You might lose some convenience, like having to log in every time, but your personal data stays in your hands. And here's one final tip. Clear your cookies regularly. Chrome, Firefox, Safari, and Edge all let you delete stored cookies. It's a good habit that helps protect your privacy, especially if you share a device or use public computers. Cookies can make your online life easier, but they can also compromise your privacy and security. Be smart about what you accept. Allow essential cookies and say no to third-party trackers. Use secure websites, reject anything suspicious, and clean up your digital trail now and then. You have the power to take control of your data. Don't give it away for free.